Nadia doesn't believe them, but the three of us are choosing to believe that they
are telling
the truth.
I don't believe Jennifer. I think she was being kind.
I know, she's sitting there thinking, I don't believe them, I believe them. Anyway, well, she might have got off the plane. It seems that all-important ingredient, timing, it wasn't there for Ross and Rachel. Now, Sunetra, it played a big part in your relationship, didn't it?
Yeah, I think timing is really important and I love the fact that you keep referring to me as the Rachel.
It's been very painful for Sunetra all the way through
what
the show.
I'm like Jennifer Aniston. No, I'm not. But what I did have was a really similar friendship group. There were three girls, three boys, and we were best friends. And we were all genuinely proper mates. And back in the days when boys and girls were just friends, and then Scott and I were the only ones who ended up actually getting into a relationship. Aww. And we'd be on and we'd be off. We were on a break. Maybe it was a half-term break and not actually a break. We did a lot of this on and off business, but we were really, we were solid friends, the six of us. And then, you know, we all left college at different times. You know, it was tricky. It was, when you have a relationship, it's not as easy to stay friends when you've had something like that. And then 18 years goes by and we find each other again and the time is just right. And I do think it was because we had such a good friendship all those years ago that meeting each other again made it work for us.
And was it like an immediate reconnection?
Immediate.
Yeah.
Yeah, literally.
Really?
I think because we fast-forwarded 18 years of not knowing each other, we went straight back to where when we last saw each other.
Oh.
It was brilliant. I mean,
so
I was
you weren't
very
in
lucky.
Touch for 18 years?
Nope. Wow. I mean, that's a proper... We saw each other again after 18 years and I went back to being 18, and so did he.
Oh,
and the friends
so
that we are Chandler, well, Nikki, Jane, Simon, and Stuart, who were our Chandler, Joey, and Phoebe, etc., they were so supportive and they always knew we were trouble when we were around each other, but they tolerated us having this relationship, and we've all stayed really good, solid friends. In fact, Simon, one of our Chandler, was our best man at our wedding.
Oh, amazing.
So we have sort of brought it all back together, and I haven't watched the reunion episode yet of Friends, but I think there's something good about knowing your friends. I mean, I don't know whether you guys remember your old school friends, but I remember people's names from school, from
college. The ones that you weren't friendly with. I mean, could you look at a class photo and look at that one there and kind of know the name?
Yeah, every single person.
Could you?
Yeah.
You are kidding.
Would you
no,
not?
This isn't going to be good for me with my fear about my memory. Please don't do this.
Well, can you not remember people
no.
you went to school
I mean,
with?
I can remember my immediate friends, Dean McMillan, Veronica McNanama, but really outside of that,
you sure you
I
can remember her second name?
Manamana.
I don't think
Manamana.
McNamara. But no, I can't. And no. The awful thing is, my eldest sister can remember the names of people in my class.
Jane, can you
tell me? Well, because I'm
knew
in
Jane
touch
would.
With about six of my girlfriends from school. Mm. But when we get together, that's all we go. Oh, do you remember so and so? And do you remember so? We can remember
full
all
names
them,
as well.
Full names.
Yeah.
Full names.
Full names.
But it was interesting. The I watched a little bit of the Friends reunion, and the original writer, is it David Bright? I think his name is, and he was saying, we based it on that time in your life when your friends are
your
everything
family.
To you. Yeah. They are your like your family.
Yeah. Before you really pair off.
Yeah.
And why it's so intriguing, I think, to younger people is that they worry that when they get to that age that they're not going to have that kind of life and that intensity with their friendship.
Yeah.
And there it was. So even though I was smiling through your story, I was actually really quite envious at the same time because I think it's a real privilege to keep those friends over such a long time.
Yeah.
I mean, not always, because some people feel a great sense of failure. I say to my girls, if you don't keep friends right the way, it's not necessarily a bad thing.
As an actress, that's exactly the kind of lifestyle we live, isn't it? We have pockets of friendships and a job finishes and you move on.
Yeah.
Not like you forget them.
But what you need to know about Nadia Sunetra, she moves on. She just moves on. She said it before.
Right. I'm a gypsy. My father was a Bedouin.
If I see you on the street, you're a sailor. Another train journey and we won't be speaking. Is that what's going to happen?
Basically, 1:30, you're dead to us.
I know. She picked up your notes. She went, who's this? She did. Never mind.